Now, next definition is, let N and N dash be a non-linear space over a field F and T is from N to N dash continuous linear transformation. Then we define the norm of operator T, which is equal to supremum of norm of Tx, such that norm of x less than equal to 1. So this is a definition of a norm of T. So this is a norm of operator. So how we can define the norm of operator? Now, given part, if this is some norm space N and this is some another norm space N dash over same field, and T is from N to N dash is a continuous linear transformation. Continuous linear transformation, right? If it is a continuous linear transformation, then X is a vector belongs to N, then its image is a Tx, which belongs to N dash, so which is a member of N dash. So definition of norm of operator, which is norm of T, so this is a set consisting norm of Tx such that norm of X less than equal to 1, X belongs to N, and supremum of this set is called a norm of operator T. So this is a definition of norm of operator T, right? So this is a definition norm of a bounded linear transformation, or we can say that it is a bounded linear operator, it is a bounded linear transformation. Now, this result is very important. Here, the following three statements are equivalent, means there are the three definition of a, these are the three definition of a norm of T. So again, on same line, N and N dash be norm linear space over same field, and T from N to N dash is a bounded linear operator, the norm of T can be expressed by any one of the following. Number one, this, right? Number two, this, right? And number three, this. Clear? So we can say that the norm of T, which is equal to, here it is a equal, so this is a equal, so norm of T can be expressed by 1, 2, and 3. So all the three statements are equivalent. Remember this. Now, in order to prove, we know that the definition of norm of T, in order to prove this result, I take this number is as A. Suppose this set is A and this set is B and third set is C. So I just take this set is B and third this set is C. So first I remove these values. So this set is B and this set is C. And what is my purpose? My purpose is A, B and C. These are equivalent. If these are equivalent, yeah, these, all of these value can be expressed in term of norm of T. So what is my purpose? My purpose is norm of T, which is equal to A, which is equal to B, which is equal to C. So remember this, that is my purpose. So just check what is A, what is B and what is C. Clear? So that is my purpose to prove this result. Now first we should aware about the definition of norm of T. As we already know that what is the definition of norm of T, so norm of T which is equal to supremum of this is norm of Tx such that norm of x which is less than equal to 1. So this is a norm of T. Second, what is A? So A is supremum of norm of Tx such that norm of x which is equal to 1, right? And what is B? So I repeat, B is supremum of norm of Tx over norm of x. X is some non-zero vector and x belongs to member of n. So all x belongs to member of n, right? And what is C? So C is infimum of all positive number k such that norm of Tx less than equal to k into norm of x. What is k? K is positive number. So this k is greater than equal to 0. So here you can also write it as k is some positive number. So this is a, this is b, and this is c. And all these are supremum, infimum. It means all of these members are numbers. So my aim is to show that all of these values are equal. Right? Now, if that is my aim, now we know that by definition of bounded linear operator, that we already know that. What is the definition of bounded linear operator? Since T is a bounded linear operator, then it implies norm of Tx which is less than equal to C norm of x, right? So this is a definition of bounded linear operator. C is a constant here, so we can also use as k. So I am taking C, so this is a bounded linear operator. So by definition of bounded linear operator, this value is this. Now, if norm of x less than equal to 1, then it implies norm of Tx which is less than equal to C, right? For every x belongs to n. Clear? So this is the definition. Now it implies supremum of set norm of Tx, right? So norm of Tx such that supremum of norm of Tx, x belongs to n and norm of x less than equal to 1. This supremum is less than equal to C. So this is a C. Now what is this value? So this is a definition of norm. So it implies norm of T which is less than equal to vector C, so which is equation number 1, right? Why it is less than C? Now this C is basically infimum of this k, right? So if you can used here k vector, we can also used it as k. So this is a k and this is a, it implies this value is k. Here it implies this value is k, right? So this value is k. and we know that if it is less than equal to k and k is less than equal to infimum of set of all k which satisfy this condition, right? So both are the same, it implies it is less than equal to k. So we can also, I can write it as in this way. So this is k is less than equal to, because it is a infimum, k is greater than equal to 0, and norm of tx less than equal to k into norm of x, right? So it means, what is this? This is a c, this is a c. What is this? This is a norm of t. So from both these equations, what we get? We get a norm of t which is less than equal to c. So which is less than equal to c. So we get first result. Now from this, compare b and c. So from by definition of b and c, clear? What is c? C is the infimum of k. And what is k? K is a number greater than equal to norm of tx over norm of x, right? So if this number is greater than equal to this values, then its infimum is also greater than equal to this values, right? Clear? So it means, from this we get, by definition, from this, this is a supremum and this is a infimum. So similarly, by definition of b and c, by definition of b and c, we get c is less than equal to b, right? What was c? C is a infimum and it is a supremum, both the same value. Here what we get? K is greater than equal to norm of tx over norm of x. So what is its infimum? Infimum of k is smaller value, that is a norm of tx, this. And what is the supremum of this? That is greater than this values. So that why b is greater than equal to c. Clear? So just do it one and two times, then you will definitely understand. So c is less than equal to b, so we get number two result. Now comparison between b and a. Now if x is not equal to 0, if x is not equal to 0, then we know that norm of tx over norm of x, this is by bounded operator, by definition t of x over norm of x, this values. Now its norm is 1. Now since norm of x over norm of x, which is equal to 1. So what we conclude? We conclude the relation between b and a. So what is b? B is, so just see that, what is b? So this is a b and this is a, right? From this this values, so its norm is equal to 1, clear? So this is supremum, right? If this is a supremum of this values and norm of x over norm of x equal to 1, then it implies, from this it implies b is less than equal to, b is less than equal to a, right? So c is less than equal to b and b is less than equal to a, so which is equation number 3. So from 1, 2 and 3, what we get? From 1, 2 and 3, we get norm of t, which is equal to, which is norm of t, which is equal to norm of t, which is less than equal to c, less than equal to c, which is less than equal to b, and which is less than equal to a, right? So that is a relation. If we prove that a is less than equal to norm of t, then it satisfies all the conditions are equivalent. Now what is a? We know that. What is a? A is equal to supremum of norm of tx, such that norm of x equal to 1, clear? And what is norm of t? So norm of t is supremum of norm of tx, such that norm of x less than equal to 1. So this is a bigger set because it is a less and equal, it contains equal. So this is a smaller set, it means a is less than equal to this values. So from this we get this is less than equal to norm of t. If this value is satisfied, then it implies norm of t, which is equal to a, which is equal to b, which is equal to c. So it means the definition of norm of t can be expressed in the four way. One is in the form of a, second is in the form of b, third is in the form of c. So we express in the four ways. So what is the value in that ways? So that is a norm of t. This can be expressed as number one definition, supremum of norm of tx, such that norm of x less than equal to 1. This is the first definition. And second definition that we represented in term of a, so that is a norm of t, which is a supremum of norm of tx, such that norm of x which is equal to 1. And what is third definition? Third definition is norm of t, so which is equal to supremum of norm of tx over norm of x, such that x belongs to n. This is a third definition. And fourth definition, norm of t, which is a infimum of set k, where k is greater than equal to 0, and norm of tx less than equal to k, this is norm of x, right? Now from this fourth result, this is satisfied for all k, also satisfied for the infimum of this k. What is the infimum of k? That is a norm of t. So in addition to this, our condition is satisfied. The fifth result is, that is from this, norm of tx, which is less than equal to norm of t into norm of x, right? So all the five result are we get from the bounded linear transformation. So remember all the five result, that is very important for the next study. This is a bounded linear transformations. Clear? Now, I just repeat here I just repeat what we did in the previous lectures. Now, what we did first, I take a n as a vector space, so which is a vector space over a field f, it may be R, it may be C. So it may be R, it may be C, right? Then I define a sum function from N to R, and it satisfy four properties, and that is called a function norm. If we define this norm, then any vector space with this norm is called a normed linear space, right? If it is a complete, in next step, if it is a complete, then this is a called a Banach space, right? This is a called a Banach space. So remember the basic result. So this is a called a Banach space. Then we take two n and n dash norm linear spaces, and T is some linear transformation n to n dash, so which is a linear transformation. So this is a linear transformation. If it is a linear transformation, and this linear transformation is called a bounded or continuous, this is a called a bounded or continuous, if it satisfy this condition k into norm of x, right? Then after that we define the norm of operator, which is norm of T. So this is a supremum of norm of Tx, such that norm of x less than equal to 1. Again we define A, we define B, we define C. So all A, B, C are also expressed as in term of norm of T, right? So here we define a new term, which is a norm of operator, clear? So that we define only for a bounded linear operator. Now what is B, N and N dash, right? So this is a set of all bounded linear transformation, right? Clear? So if we take any operator B, N, N dash, so here we define a function, this will supremum of this norm of Tx and this norm of x less than equal to 1. We define this value. Now this function, this value will be norm of this vector space if it satisfy four properties. Property number 1, this must be positive. Property number 2, if this is 0, then if and only if this 0. Property number 3, triangle inequality, which is T plus T dash less than equal to this plus this norm of T dash. Property number 4, norm of alpha T, which is equal to absolute value of alpha into norm of t. If satisfy all these four properties, then it will be norm of this vector space. If it will be norm of this vector space, and if it will be complete, then it will be converted to Banach space. So that is the our next aim, to prove that this is a non-linear space with this norm, and it is a Banach space under some condition. So that we will do in the next lecture.